Welcome, Thomas.
Hello, Reini.
As our product manager for the Zenon Analyzer, can you give us some insights on how we can support the energy industry with that product?
Yeah, of course. I've brought something along with me here, and today I will show you something about EDMS systems, and that means reports concerning EDMS systems and reports who give you more information than you know from usual EDMS systems, because we know what is an EDMS system report. They show, for instance, energy consumption, energy flows, or maybe Sankey diagrams and such things. But what they cannot do, they give you not more information concerning your production.
Okay, so nothing beside the energy stuff.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. And I just want to show you one report I have brought with me. So here in this report, we see what we can do with the zenon analyzer. We can do a lot more than just EDMS systems can do. Okay. In this chart we see the blue bars show us the energy consumption, and the red line is the production, our produced units, how much units we have produced in this time. And here we see they correlate. We see we have a higher energy consumption when you produce more, and of course less energy consumption when you produce
sense.
Yes.
Yeah.
Makes sense, yes. Yeah. But we also see that there are some times, for instance here in this bar chart, we have a high energy consumption but no production. So that indicates that there's something wrong, or maybe we have to look what is happening here at this time.
So this is something that we should investigate normally and say, okay, here we have obviously a problem.
Exactly, exactly. And you know, this is one of the strengths that we can correlate our EDMS data together with our production data and combine them in one report.
Yeah, this sounds...
And I have brought with you another similar report.
Yeah.
Here we can calculate the relative consumption. That means we have again here a bar chart, but this bar chart does not show us the energy consumption. It shows us the energy consumption per produced unit. So it's again,
so this is possible.
We correlate exactly the consumption with our production and see how good are we, how much energy do we need to produce one piece.
So it's good to analyze the fingerprint of a facility or something.
Exactly, like exactly, exactly.
Okay, what does this line in there mean? So this
here, this line in the middle is, we call it scale break.
Okay.
It means if we have very high bars,
high differences. In the
exactly. Okay. So we see, when you look at the scale, we see we have here an interrupt. Yeah. That otherwise we couldn't read the very small figures because they are just very small bars and so on. Exactly, exactly. And we can even go one step further with the zenon analyzer. We can, for instance, also give some additional information in the report. So we have the same bar chart report again, but we also use it together with an efficiency class diagram. That means here we have the average consumption, energy consumption
overall.
We need overall per produced unit, and we see exactly if we how good our production is. So it is in between C, nearly D, so
almost
it's almost good, but it can do better.
Okay. So is this something I can define on my own, or is this a standardized range?
Exactly. This is also a very good question. How can we create, or how can the customer create such a report? And with the zenon analyzer, we have a tool where it's very easy to create such a report. We have the zenon analyzer management studio, and here we see the screen of the first energy report I showed you, where we see how much amount we needed per produced unit.
Yeah.
And for instance, if we want to extend this report by efficiency class diagram, we have here this plus button. Can we get the selection of which report template we want to use, exactly, and then we choose the correct report template, say okay, and we get some additional filter and settings we can choose, parameters.
Yeah.
Most of them are already predefined correctly, so we don't have any errors or additional settings we need to use here. And finally, we just need to extend the report we want to show to the customers. So for instance, we make it a bit wider. Yeah. In the design area, we say we want now here to add an efficiency class diagram. We add this diagram here, say it should have this size, and then we can, for instance, insert the same information we have in the diagram as a table. So we insert here a table and say we want to add this efficiency class.
So these are all templates we can reuse very simply
and
configure a little bit to our needs.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And that's it. And now these were all steps to add such an efficiency class diagram to the report. So we can now deploy it, create the report, and then we have exactly a report we see here in this example.
Wow. Makes absolutely sense to me.
Yeah. And so we can really, a customer can really create tailor-made reports according to his needs with this product. We are not very strict with our report templates. You see, you can modify them exactly as you want them, as you need them, and get the result you need.
Great. Thanks a lot for joining me in today's session of Engineer's Kitchen. I have a small present for you.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks again for joining us today, and I hope I can soon see you again in another session.
Yeah, of course. It was a pleasure to be here and to show you this functionality we have here. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.